Now, next, I want to talk about something I'm a little confused by. I'm excited, but I'm also very skeptical. And this is that Porsche and BMW unveiled this new EV charger that 3 times faster than Tesla's. Of course, that's what everything is based upon. But the thing about it is that it has a 450 kilowatt rate, which is the speed at which it charges, which is, yeah, I don't know, triple or so what Tesla's currently at with 120 kilowatt charger. But the deal is while that's incredibly fast, and I think, you know, that's great to see charging happen at a faster rate, cars can't really handle this yet. No car really out on the road will be able to accept this fast of a charge. And the challenge with that is it goes back to what Elon and JB were talking about on the earnings call, where you can, you know, you could have a 1 megawatt charger, but the battery won't last as long because of the changes in the chemistry or the design in order to be able to accept that charge. So it's a question. I think there's a trade-off here. It's not just pump more electricity in at faster rate. There has to be something with the battery to be able to then accept that and maintain that charge. So I'm not sure what the future looks like, but Tesla is reported to be coming out with the new supercharger V3 system, which will be, I think, around 220 to 250 kilowatts. So pretty quick, you know, double what they have now. And in fact, tomorrow at the Boring Company event in LA, which I will be at, we may get more. I know it's a Boring Company event, but I believe Elon's doing the presentation and it's at the Hawthorne facility. Very Tesla-like, you know, everyone I know at Tesla is the one that are talking to me about it. So we may get some more interesting stuff there. But with this, I mean, I love this. I love that we're pushing the boundaries of this stuff and we're increasing it. I do have a video that I'm working on right now talking about this, because while electric cars for 80% of your use case are already here, right? Majority of people don't drive more than, what, 60, 70 miles in a day. Now, you know, even expand that out to where it's even more people, you know, you're talking a couple hundred miles a day, you can buy a car, an electric car, that will fulfill those needs. No problem, hands down, it's solved. However, a gas car will have a tremendously bigger range than an EV and is extremely more convenient to refuel, to charge. So I was doing some basic math on it, and I'm gonna do a video kind of diving deeper on this, where if you look at a Honda Civic, it'll go about 450 miles on a charge, on a full gas tank, 12.4 gallon gas tank. And with that, they can refuel in 5 minutes. Right? Maybe 10 minutes, we'll call it 10 minutes. Compare that to even the best EV in the world right now with the best charging network, and it is dramatically less convenient. Now again, it doesn't always, you know, the majority of times you don't need that, but if you're like me and you want to see a future where we don't have any fossil fuel-based modes of transportation, gas, diesel, whatever, then that's what we have to strive for. We have to strive for parity in terms of convenience. And so that's where this charging story, I'm like stoked that we're getting up in the 450, 400 plus kilowatt range. But in order to achieve similar parity to what a gas car would get, you'd have to be well over 1 megawatt. And I mean, I'm not an electrical engineer, so I don't know how hard or kind of impossible or improbable that may even be. But yeah, stay tuned, because I'm doing some math on this and I'm gonna have a video breaking it down soon. Well, hopefully after the Boring event next week. So